this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Orion region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. The Running Man Nebula. The Witch Head Nebula. And NGC 2261, Hubble's Variable Nebula.
All right, let's go star hopping. Star hopping. Star hopping. Star hopping.
Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 44 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm extremely thankful to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. Well, once again, it's Thanksgiving in the United States, and I'm in the Florida Keys as usual with my family. However, I did shoot this episode back at the observatory studio this year, so we won't have any noisy wind blowing like we did in episode 9 of Star Hopping. But interestingly enough, in that episode, we were looking right in the same area that we'll be exploring tonight. Before I get into tonight's star hopping targets, I do want to recognize, in the spirit of Thanksgiving, how thankful I am to have all of you continuing to watch star hopping on a regular basis. We have right around 400 subscribers on our YouTube channel, and we're pushing 600 followers on Facebook. You all have stuck with me for over a year of the show, and I just want to say thank you for your time and continued interest in star hopping. So we have three interesting objects tonight, one very bright, one very faint, and one very small. Let's start off easy with the big bright one, otherwise known as a BBO. We'll find it right after this message. Kissimmee Park Observatory would like to thank our wonderful supporters on Patreon. Your contributions will allow us to create and provide more quality astronomy content. We appreciate your generosity and support.
Hopping target number one.
The Running Man Nebula, also cataloged as NGC 1977, is right beside the massively impressive Orion Nebula. In many of the wide field images of the nebula, it is included. It lies just above the main part of M42 and M43. M42 is the main Orion Nebula. M43 is the little comma-shaped nebula above it. And then above that, toward Orion's belt, lies NGC 1977. I've seen online that this nebula actually has three entries in the NGC, 1973, 1975, and 1977. I do see the nebula generally referenced as 1977, so we'll stick with that. It's called the Running Man Nebula due to the shape of an interesting foreground dust cloud in the front of the brightest part of the nebula that looks like the shape of a man that is running. The nebula only very recently got its name, and that was credited to Jason Ware, the famous astrophotographer from Texas. He was showing the nebula to one of his neighbors, and they thought it looked like a man running in a race. Jason mentioned it to his astronomy club one time, and the name took off from there. Finding the Running Man is simple, since it's part of the Orion Nebula complex. Most people, even non-astronomers, have seen or can recognize the belt of Orion, formed by the three bright stars Alnitak, Alnilam, and Mintaka. Below this line of stars is another perpendicular and somewhat fainter trio of stars that form the sword of Orion. The center one is actually the Orion Nebula. See how it looks fuzzy to the naked eye? Find that in your scope, ogle it a bit, and when your head stops spinning, look at the pair of stars above M42. These are 4th magnitude C Orionis and 5th magnitude 45 Orionis. The Running Man Nebula is the wispy haze that surrounds these stars. We'll move on to our next target that is extremely faint, and is really more suited to our previous holiday of Halloween. We'll see the spooky and very faint nebula right after this break.
Star hopping target number two.
The Witch Head Nebula is most definitely a photographic target. Nope. You can't see this one in your telescope, but I wanted to present it because it's one of the most interesting nebulae in the area. If you're an astrophotographer and have a dark sight, then these location instructions will be just for you. The rest of us can just enjoy the pretty images. And the image is very spooky, right? The shape reminds me of the Wicked Witch of the West in The Wizard of Oz. This is one of the few nebula that really match their namesake. The Witch Head is cataloged as IC-2118 in the Index Catalog. It lies just to the right of the bright blue beacon star Rigel, the brightest star in Orion, just across the border into the constellation of Eridanus, the river. The Witch Head is a reflection nebula, and it's seen because it's reflecting the light from Rigel. Now, Rigel is a blue star, and therefore the nebula appears blue. Also, the dust grains in the nebula tend to absorb the other colors in the spectrum and reflects back blue, similar to the phenomenon that gives Earth its blue sky. So see, that was a bonus fact you learned on star hopping. So if anyone asks you why the sky is blue, now you can tell them. To line up your camera on the Witch Head, you'll need a pretty wide-angle lens, since this huge nebula extends 3 degrees by 1 degree. Starting on Rigel, look 3 degrees to the upper left to locate second magnitude Cursa, which is Beta Eridani, the second brightest star in the constellation of Eridanus. About 2.5 degrees to the right of Cursa lies fourth magnitude Psi Eridani. The Witch Head lies inside this triangle of stars and lies closest to Psi. I really need to try to capture this nebula with my new Canon lens, perhaps in the next couple new moons. The Witch Head lies about 900 light years from Earth. So the last target for this week is pretty small, but easy to pick up, especially with a nebular filter. We'll hunt it down right after this.
Star hopping target number 3.
Hubble's Variable Nebula lies in the constellation of Monoceros, very close to the Christmas Tree Cluster and the Rosette Nebula that we shared with you in episode 9 of Star Hopping. Hubble's Variable is cataloged as NGC 2261, and it's associated with the variable star R Monoceratus. So since it's lit up by a variable star, the nebula itself changes magnitude brightness from 10th to 12th magnitude. Apparently, the scattering of light by the nebula brightens it up a little bit because the nebula itself is said to be 9th magnitude. Also, as I mentioned, it's not very big, spanning only 4 minutes of arc. The nebula is actually fan-shaped, which gives it the appearance of a comet. It was actually mistaken for one when it was discovered in 1783 by William Herschel. When he saw that it didn't move in relation to the stars over time, he concluded it was indeed a nebula. The variability in brightness was not really detected until Edwin Hubble used the 200-inch telescope on Mount Palomar to measure its brightness, hence the name of the nebula. To locate Hubble's variable, we'll start at the bright second magnitude star in Gemini, Alhena, found about 15 degrees to the lower left of Orange Betelgeuse. So start out by moving about 3 degrees to the lower right to third magnitude Alzeir. Now move 3 degrees to the right, crossing the border into Monoceros, to 4th magnitude 15 Monoceratus. This is the bright star in the base of the Christmas Tree Cluster, so have a look around while you're here. Now move a half degree to the opposite end of the Christmas Tree to a 7th magnitude star. Kind of faint, but you should be able to find it. Now move about 3/4 of a degree to the right, and you should see Hubble's Variable Nebula coming into view. If you're not sure, pop in a nebula filter like an oxygen 3 filter, and it'll make the nebula pop right out. The variable star R Monoceratus is usually lost in the high surface brightness of the structure of the nebula, yet the whole thing varies in brightness by as much as 2 magnitudes with really no predictable timetable. It's thought that this variability may be related to the dark masses of dust in the nebula shadowing the star. So that was another 3 great deep sky objects. Large and bright, large and faint, and small and faint. We started out with the Running Man Nebula, NGC 1977, associated with the Orion Nebula Complex. Then we went back to Halloween and determined the position of the Witch Head Nebula for you astrophotographers out there. If you do get a shot of the Witch Head, send it in and we'll feature it on the show. Lastly, we moved into the neighboring constellation of Monoceros and tracked down the elusive Hubble's Variable Nebula. So that does it for this week's episode. You can find the show notes on our website at kpobservatory.org/SH044, where you can comment and leave any questions that you may have. You can also contact me personally on Twitter at StarhoppingMan, where I'd love to help you with any astronomy observing questions. So feel free to reach out with your questions. I'm here to help. Well, again, thank you very much for joining me here, and I'll see you next time with more star hopping tips and tricks.
I'm Cassie, and I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these video astronomy tutorials and the associated podcast every other week on Thursdays. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them on the internet. The reason we create these videos and podcasts is to help beginning amateur astronomers learn the sky and get more enjoyment out of their telescopes and astronomy in general. If you have any requests for potential targets in the night sky that you would like to see us discuss, just let us know down in the comments section below or on our website blog. Don't miss our free field notes for this episode, basically the script of the show, with all the images and star charts we use for our star hopping activities. You can get them for free at kpobservatory.org/fieldnotes. If this is the first time you're checking out star hopping, and if you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel by clicking the big yellow button, click the thumbs up on the video, and please share this tutorial out to your friends who like looking at stars. Also, as I just mentioned, please feel free to leave any question or comment below, and we'll be sure to respond quickly. Please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astronomical digital images, and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places in cyberspace, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value, and if you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a small amount per video, you can support our efforts, and help us make even more great astronomy tutorials, just like this one. So bye for now, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.